Hi, boys and girls. It's Pastor Suzanne in Alaska, and I have more stories from the Word of God for us today. Did you know that one time God made a donkey talk? It's true, He really did, and we're going to learn about that today. And we're also going to have a story about spies. It's exciting. The Word of God is full of so many amazing stories. And so that's why I enjoy sharing them with you. So if you're ready, let's begin today's story. It's called Balaam's Donkey Speaks. All right, let's go. King Balak of Moab sent for Balaam, a prophet of God, and he offered him money if he would ask God to send some great evil on the Israelites. Well, because Balaam loved money, he agreed to do this bad thing, and he started down the road on his donkey to do it. And this made God angry, and he sent an angel with the sword to stand in the road and kill him. Balaam couldn't see the angel, but his donkey could. And when the donkey went off the road to keep away from the angel, Balaam beat her for misbehaving. Then God made the donkey speak. "Why are you beating me?" the donkey asked. Then God opened Balaam's eyes and he saw the angel and was frightened. God told Balaam to bless the Israelites and not to curse them. See, there is Balaam with the donkey and the angel. That's pretty serious, isn't it? Wow, if God makes a donkey speak so he could see that angel, that is very, very interesting. And now we're moving on to Rahab and the spies. While the Israelites were still in the wilderness, Moses died. And then God said to Joshua, "You must lead the Israelites across the Jordan River into the promised land. Do not be afraid, because I'm going to be with you." While the Israelites were getting ready to go, Joshua sent two spies across the river to spy on the city of Jericho. There they met a woman who was named Rahab, and she knew that God was helping the Israelites. When the king of Jericho sent his soldiers to capture the spies, Rahab hid them on her roof under some straw until the soldiers left. And then she helped the two men to climb down a rope on the outside of the city wall. Before they left, she asked them not to hurt her and her family when they attacked the city of Jericho. The spies promised not to, and they told her to hang a red rope from the window of her house so that they would recognize it again. And then they returned to Joshua and told him all that had happened. See, there's the spies. They're hiding on her roof under the straw. And there's the king's men trying to find them. It's pretty exciting, huh? Well, let's see what happens next. Joshua and all the people got up early the next morning and traveled to the Jordan River, and they camped beside it for 3 days. Then Joshua told the people to get ready to cross that river, and God was going to do a great miracle, and they would walk across on dry ground. Now, 40 years earlier, their moms and dads had got to do the same thing when God opened up the Red Sea. Remember, we learned about that. And now they're getting to experience it the same way that their moms and dads did, with a new leader, Joshua. Joshua was one of the two spies originally who went in and looked at the land, and they said that God was going to give it to him. And so Joshua and Caleb were allowed to go into the promised land, but everybody else that was older, they didn't get to. They all died. They could not receive the promise, but their kids did. And so this is what we're learning about right now. Their kids are finally getting ready to go into that promised land. The priests went first, carrying the Ark of the Covenant, the special box that held the Ten Commandments. And as soon as the priests got their feet into the water and it touched the water dried up in front of them, and all the people walked across on dry ground. The priest built a stone monument in the middle of the river so that everyone who saw it would remember what God had done for the people. And then when everyone had gone across, the priest carried the ark out of the river and the water began flowing again. how they're going to take the city, the Battle of Jericho. God came to Joshua and told him the Israelites would capture the city of Jericho, even though it was surrounded by high walls. Jericho was part of the Promised Land. That was going to be the first city that they would conquer. And God was giving that land to his people. God told Joshua how to plan his attack. He said that all of the Israelite soldiers must march around the city once each day for 6 days. Can we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days they had to march around that whole walled city. And the priests would go before them carrying the Ark of the Covenant on their shoulders. 7 priests were to go ahead of the Ark and blow trumpets. And their trumpets were like ram's horns. Have you ever seen a goat or a ram and they have horns? That's what they would blow into. On the 7th day, they were to march around Jericho, not once, but 7 times. And at the end of the 7th time around, the priests were to blow the trumpets with a loud, long blast. And the army was to give a mighty shout. And then the walls of the city would fall down flat, and the Israelites could walk right into it. So the Israelite army did as God commanded. Once each day for 6 days, they marched around the city. And on the 7th day, after marching 7 times around the wall, they blew the trumpets and the people shouted and the walls came crashing down. And then the Israelites rushed into Jericho and captured it. But Rahab, remember Rahab? She protected the spies. Rahab and her family were not hurt, just as the spies had promised. There is Joshua saying, shout. Let's see. Whoa, look. The walls came tumbling down. God always keeps his promises. Always keeps his promises. And he works in mysterious ways, like making donkeys talk. And he uses all kinds of people to do his will. Like he used Rahab, who didn't even know God personally yet. But he used Rahab to protect his people. And Rahab was protected because she obeyed and she helped God's people. So we can all be used from God. We just need to say yes, and he will be happy to use us to do amazing things for him. I want to pray for us right now. So Father God, I thank you for your word with the wonderful stories, how you work in amazing ways and you use all kinds of people and sometimes even animals to accomplish your purposes. And so Father, we just thank you for these boys and girls that are listening, that they would learn to know you in such a close way that you would be their very best friend and that they would make themselves open to be used by you in doing great things for the kingdom of God. Watch over and protect them. Keep them safe. Keep them healthy. And most importantly, help them to keep you in their heart all the days of their life. We love you, Jesus. And it's in your name that we pray. Amen. So I hoped you liked our stories today. We learned about the talking donkey and Balaam. We learned about Rahab and the spies. We learned about Joshua and the plans to take the city of Jericho. And we learned about the Battle of Jericho, that they didn't have to use cannons and guns. They marched quietly and they used a ram horn and a shout. And God fought the battle for them and brought the enemy down, and he opened up that city for them to take. God is so amazing, and we love him and we want to serve him. So until next time, be good. I love you. God loves you too. And we'll be back again with another story from God's Word, the Bible. Till next time, this is Pastor Suzanne in Alaska saying bye-bye. Bye-bye.